One thing that gets a lot of controversy right now in the karate community is the scorpion kick. A lot of people talk about it as not being effective or not having a lot of power in the way it's thrown in sport kumite. So what we're going to do today is take a look at how you can use this kick for practical street self-defense purposes. Of course, anytime you take a kick and use it for street self-defense, you're not going to be lifting your leg as high. From here, if he has a haymaker and I've brought him down for a knee strike or even a headlock and I decide I need to finish with a kick, I can shove his head down and throw this scorpion kick up to the face, hitting with the back of the heel. This bone on the back of the heel is very sharp and penetrating. And to generate my power, just like any other good karate technique, I'm gonna turn my hips and drive my leg upward at the same time to generate the power for that hit. Another example is maybe he has two punches coming in and I get trapped up here in the middle. I can smash his face with the shoulder. I can knee strike. As his head comes down, this leg will come up same time, smashing into his face with, again, the back of my foot and heel. Remember on this to strike on your way in, use your legs and your arms, elbows, forearm to hit. And then when you start controlling the head downward, remember not to grab too low on the neck because he'll be able to stand up and overpower. You actually want to come in and control the head. Once you get the head to this lowered position, it's easy enough to slam that heel into his face.